Welcome back to Let's Play Legend of Heroes, Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're here, as you saw, in Nelva. Says it's, Castle Town. And, guard here, hello. Menoth's soldier says, "You must be travelers. Something terrible has happened. Let me guess, Galga?" Why did Galga choose to destroy the capital of Menoth, of all places? Anything else you say? Okay. So we're gonna explore this place. We just arrived. This is like a dead-end alleyway here. Hello? Green-haired person. Jurio says, "It was incredible. Can you believe it? That monster was this big. Castle Nelva broke into pieces in a flash. It was unbelievable. I wonder where King Nordic is. I hope he wasn't killed." Hmm. Aunt Suji says, "The monster has no mercy. How can it ruin everything like this? A half of this town is underwater." Okay, you can see some of the water over there. What's going to happen now? Oh, if I know. Oh no, there's a bunny's in a bad mood. Oh, now it's happy again? Oh yeah, that was quick. Get out of my way. Anything interesting down here? Can we go in that way? It looked like a doorway. Never mind. We'll go in the normal way. Like normal people. Hello? Mrs. Lil says, "Soldiers set up a temporary command center in an inn and began reconstruction work. The castle was devastated by Galga, but that inn in Nelva is the largest in Menarth. It's ideal for the command center." But I still can't believe Galga came out of the water. I hope it's not a sign of something worse. Ravage says, "Sea monster Galga walked through it, and the castle's now completely gone. It was a terrible tragedy. It's a miracle my house was spared when the entire town was completely destroyed." Wait, anything else to say, actually? "I want to open my house to the victims of Menarth. You think it's a good idea?" "Yes, but I can't tell you that." Hey! Hey! Speak to me. Neeple? Well, that's an awkward name. "Nelva used to be the most beautiful town in Menarth, but Galga left it in shatters. You never know when the disaster will strike you." That's true. You never know. Just never, never know. Mrs. Saliva? Oh my god! Her name is Mrs. Saliva. Oh my god. You need to go to the courthouse and get that changed immediately. "The town suffered extensive damage, but fortunately no one died. As long as the people are okay, we can rebuild the town in no time." Get your name changed while you're at it. Mrs. Saliva. Good god. Bad mood. Doesn't look hungry. Praise it. Obviously showing off. Okay. Atole, the arms dealer. Oh, I'm talking to the guy behind the counter. I wanted to talk to the guy. Okay, well, never mind. "Welcome, you must be travelers. Our weapons were no match for Galga, but they may help you during your journey. Have a look around." Okay, iron sword for Jurio, better. Oh, there's a steel spear for Alf. A heavy steel spear, poorly balanced yet powerful. Iron sword is difficult to use but hard hitting. Okay. And Alf already has the iron spear. Chris has the ruby staff already. I wonder why they're selling this stuff when we have it. Wooden shield, we have that. Only Jurio can use it. Leather armor. He has a downgrade for Jurio. He's using ring. Actually, we all have ring mail on. All three of us. There's the ring mail. Moonlight robes. Okay, so it's a downgrade for Chris in defense, but an upgrade in magic defense. Chris is 34. I think I'll keep her with what she has, to tell you the truth. We have Alf. I think I'll keep him for what he has as well. Alright, so let's just get the... Is he normally 37 up to 65? No, no, wait. No, that's Chris. Jurio. 59. 65. Okay, we got the iron sword. And the iron spear. We'll get that as well. No, not iron. Steel. Oh, 500. Alright, let's do the exchange thingy. Should we get it now? There we go. You're very welcome. Stop by at any time. Or stop by any time, whatever. Let's see. Equipment. So he's using the flame dagger. Upgrading to the iron sword. And then Alf. Oh, I wonder if we should... That'd be a long travel back to get him these power rings, or, like, well, he has no magic, but get him a power ring. But that's all the way back. I'm not even sure we can get back there, because we came by ship, so that's like a story event. It's not even into Tuda, it's whatever town there is before that, Tagura, I believe. So we came from Tagura via ship, so we can't get back there to get him those things. Unfortunately. Alright, so steel spear. Now let's sell this stuff. Yes, we must be travelers. We're gonna sell the... flame dagger. For 150 piers. And the iron spear for 150 piers. Godal says, I wanted to buy weapons from this store to level the ground. We were shocked to see our town demolished, but we can't grieve forever. Hello? Menor soldier. The weapons they have in this store are excellent. The soldiers of Casa Nelva even buy them from here. This time we just had the wrong enemy. Many of us attacked together, but Galga didn't wince. Nelva's soldiers are not trained to fight monsters. You can't blame them. I do not blame them. I also finished exploring the south part of town here. Grandma Nova says, Grandpa Delito and his family must have escaped to Tatuda after their house was destroyed. I'm worried about Delito because he's old. Tatuda and Tiuyel are the only places to escape from Nelva. I like Tatuda because it's a rural town. Once things settle down, maybe I can go to Tatuda too. I need a good friend I can have a chat with over a cup of tea. That seems to be the thing to do around here. Old people have tea. Teal says, we had such a terrible ordeal. Who would have imagined such a monster might attack us? That sounds like a bad deal. Actually, we came here to buy herbs. Many of the Nelva soldiers were wounded by Galga's attack. I'm glad your story carries many herbs, Julia. Oh, bye. Jurio says soldiers are having a hard time too. Alf says I completely agree. Chris says they want to save their country, but they are no match to the monster like Galga. I feel sorry for them. By the way, Jurio says, do you think Lodi, the grandson of Grandpa Kevin on Negar Island, was able to find Galga? Chris says, at least not in Nelva. Nobody is talking about him. Who is Lodi? Alf asks. Chris says he lost his father and mother at sea when they were attacked by Galga. Since then, he's been training swordsmanship while chasing after Galga to avenge his parents' death. He is such a noble person. I pray for his success in his mission of revenge, but I doubt if humans can defeat Galga. Chris says, what's wrong, Alf? You've been contemplating. I was thinking that I should do something after looking at the devastation here. Yeah, well, don't leave our party. We just got you a new spear. Lady Julia says, welcome. What can I do for you? Okay, she sells the potions. She's also selling Safi Volume 3. We'll get that. And that's about it. May good wind help your journey, she says. Alright, let's check out Safi Volume 3, Drifting Smoke. Sophie's rapier drew glinting arcs across the night sky. Brad's cutlass parried her blows with linear yet masterful precision. It was the first time Safi was impressed by an opponent. He was the first to remain unscathed after being exposed to her lightning-quick barrage of lunges. Brad, too, was surprised by Safi's lithe, natural grace. He also realized that her strength was rooted in hatred, a strong, murderous intent against someone. Their clashing swords gave off sparks, small stars in the darkness. Their breath, white from the cold, were as nebula in the night sky. A small, thin girl, holding her own against a mighty veteran of countless battles. Viscount Tormarine was enthralled by the two duelists, almost forgetting his animosity towards Baron Garnet. Baron Garnet, on the other hand, was smoking his pipe in a strangely relaxed manner. Safi and Brad had no way of knowing the true reason for his composure. Interesting. Wow, look at that. Let me walk around the building here. Okay. How wow. Manito says, this is the first time in life I had such a fearful experience. I didn't know such a creature existed in this world. Shivers run down my back every time I remember the incident. Oh. Alright, let's finish exploring this quarter first. Some kind of healing services or church here? Maybe? Her name's Maybe. Galga destroyed my house, too. Well, yeah, maybe. I'm staying here tonight. I'll stay with Julia in the tool store. Why is her name Maybe? So I got Lady Saliva and Maybe. You're standing on a stool or something. Some kind of chair. Callow says, our house is gone, but we're okay. We'll be staying here. She says she's staying with Julia in the tools shed, so I don't know. Might be ditching you. Hello? Rint the Chapel Master says, our chapel is like this, but please stay as long as you want. Oh no, it doesn't look like we can rest here. Oh, what'd you find? Cure potion? You cannot carry that. We're limited to 10. Stacks of 10. Alright, talk to her. That's Julia. Doesn't it look awful? Seawater came in and flooded everywhere. Maybe we should rebuild the whole thing into a port town. Look at the extent of damage. Honestly, we can't begin to think about where we should start. Perhaps with your grammar. I think it's faster to rebuild a house from scratch than to repair it. I think the whole incident gave Bandy a big blow. He has been standing there like that ever since his house was shattered. A majority of houses in Nelva suffered more or less the same. Was Bandy? Oh no, my house. What should I do? Cappy says, "Damn you, Galga. My house was also destroyed. But why did it suddenly come out? It's strange." I don't know why it suddenly came out. Did I talk to you yet? Yeah. I did talk to her. Did I talk to these people? Yeah, I did. What's going to happen now? You will die. In complete suffering and torment. Just want to make sure I don't miss any of these random people. I talked to him. I think I've seen everything. It's not as big as it looks once you come back around. Alright. Let's go to the next quarter or district. Excuse me. Let me talk to you. Hoi. Bill says, "Oh, hi. My place was spared, but I can't be happy because of such a devastation the town suffered. I also feel sorry for those who have lost their house. Besides, I don't want to be called inhumane or cold. I can't just smile about my good fortune. I should wear a serious face in times like this." Okay. You seem you're more worried about what people will think of you than worried about people. Grandpa Manon says, "I just saw King Nordic and his guards heading to Yuyal. Since the castle is gone, I think they'll stay into Yuyal until Nelva is restored. The king should stay with his people and rally strength in the country in times of crisis like this. I know the king has his idea, but he should let us know." There was a whole bunch of people gathered in there. Oh. What's up? You hungry again or something? Not hungry yet. I will praise you. Captain Dunk says, "Listen, Nelva is facing a crisis. We shall bring back lights and laughters to this town. We shall also restore Castle Nelva to welcome back King Nordic as soon as possible. Everyone, get to your post." The Menloth soldiers go, "Oh!" "Hey," Captain Dunk says, "come out of the door." "I can't." Yo-Yo says, "So strict." Chris says, "But I can feel their commitment to rebuilding this town as soon as possible." And Alf says, "Soldiers devote themselves to their country. That is an ideal spirit." Let's talk to Captain Dunk. "Oh, travelers. I'm sorry, but this inn is used as a temporary command center of the Nelva army. We have no room for you to stay. Don't wander around much." Let's talk to these soldiers. "First, we need temporary houses to protect the people against the wind and rain. And secondly, when I was small, I used to help my father at work. He was the village's best carpenter." Alright, there's another area off of here. Okay. Penne? "Are you looking for a room? I'm Penne, a daughter of this inn. I would enjoy you with vodka sauce. Can we stay here tonight?" Chris says. "I'm sorry, all our rooms will be used to accommodate the soldiers for a while, so we're closed to the public. Wounded soldiers are also resting in the back rooms. We have our hands full. Sorry. Many soldiers will come back after dark, so we don't have rooms for you to sleep. But you can take a rest until then. Oh. We could get some rest here, yes. Okay. Wow. Must be windy through here. Ah. I think I saw you in a Metallica video. Actually, there's a... Your potion? Yeah, you have... Mind potion that we can use. You have an eye open, though. Damn it! This is the most important time for this country, but I can't move because of injury. This is most unfortunate. Galga appeared from the sea as if a mountain had attacked us, but the monster is mortal, too. The next time it comes, I'll certainly retaliate. Ouch! My wound aches when I get too excited. I'm a proud soldier of Nelva. I'll get well soon and help restore this town. Bajul says, I'm sorry. I'll give you extra service when you come by next time. Please come back when things are settled. Extra service. Oh, wait. What do you got? Mind potion. We're full. Wait. Nope, we don't need that. Did I talk to this one? We'll show you the spirit of the proud Nelva soldiers. I think these guys came from that meeting. I'll bring back the town I grew up in. Whatever it takes. That's Bill again. Big Bad Bill is Sweet William now. Get back here. Cole says, the king left for Taiyuyao with his guards a while ago. The road to Taiyuyao is closed for now so that the king and his company can travel smoothly. Yeah, tell me about all the roads are closed and blocked and stuff. People in high positions are selfish. I suppose so. You must be travelers. We are closing the road until King Nordic arrives at Taiyuyao. Could you wait for a while in Nelva? Our bunny found something, but yeah. Missed it. Alright, so I think we're just going in here. This is a more narrow section. Well, there is an up... stuff up here, though. Oh, wow. Well, let's talk to these guys first. Who would have thought the biggest town in Nelva would be destroyed so easily? Alright, let's sweat a little. What? Why are we gonna sweat a little? I can't get through you. Past you. Can't go that way, he's blocking. I'll talk to you in a second. Bado says, unlike chapel spells, many can spells are offensive. They're useful in driving away monsters, but not everyone can use the can spells. Like the users of the chapel spells, you need natural talent to use the can spells. If you're traveling, I think having a company who can use the can spells in your party will be a great help. Oh, thanks for the advice. Is that what, Chris knows? He knows spirit magic. Okay, I don't know about can spells. Mrs. Shimela says, I heard King Nordic evacuated to Taiyuyao. People in high positions always have a place to escape. Yeah, pretty much. Hi. Galad the Canned Master says people of Tirasweel used to be able to cast stronger spells, but they regarded spells as just formality and didn't utilize the power. As a result, when Galga attacked the country, they knew no magic could help them. What a tragedy, don't you think? I have no face to show to the witches who came here across the ocean to give us magic power. No face to show. What does that mean? Hungry! It's feeding time at the zoo. I'll give you Sky Base. I like angel food. Oh, reluctantly with that one too, huh? You don't like the angel food that much? I'm gonna picky rabbit over here. Yo-Yo says, I can't believe the castle is really gone. It's kind of scary, Chris says. Alf says, every time Galga lands, it becomes more violent. We must do something. But what? Oh, there's a boat. Who's that? Oh, it's Lodi. He says, damn you, Galga. I'll kill you with my own hands. I think you're about the size of Galga's eye, so I'm not sure how you would do that. Nonetheless, I guess he's gonna give it his best shot. Okay. Hello. I'll talk to him in a sec. Oh, I can't go up there. So I'll talk to him now. Elder Ugana says, well, he's quoting something. An evil mountain will appear from the sea and leave the town in ruins. This is what she was saying about... Elf says, what did you just say? Well, a girl who visited this town a long time ago left these words. He's talking about the Moonlight Witch. A girl? I shall say she was the Moonlight Witch, Elf says. Chris says, I shall say. Alf, you sound funny again. Yurio says, but wait. How do you know about the Moonlight Witch? She left the same prophecy in my country. By the way, we never asked where you came from, Alf. I am from Ambush. Chris says, oh, that makes sense. That's why you knew about the Shrine of Agunis in Ambush. Right. I'm surprised to know the Moonlight Witch left the same prophecy here. Ugana says, Alf, if I may call you that, please listen. Nelva was destroyed just as the prophecy said. If the same prophecy exists about Ambush, you should hurry home. Go back to your country as soon as possible and tell your king about Galga's attack. Galga destroyed Nelva despite the prophecy. You shouldn't let these words go to waste like the people in Nelva. Old man, thank you for your advice. Chris says, we can't waste any more time. Let's leave. You're right, Yurio says. Yurio, Alf, we should tell the King of Ambush about Galga. Hurry. But you are on your pilgrimage, Alf says. This is more important. That's right, Yurio says. We're also heading to Agunis, which is in the same direction. Many lives are at stake. We can't ignore. Thank you. You are my best traveling companions. Galga will appear again. Hurry your way to Ambush. Oh, wait, well, will the guard let us go? That's the question. I think it's this way. Is it? Wait, no. Sorry to keep you waiting. We got a report saying that King Nordic arrived at Tutuyel. Tutuyel. You can go now. Travel safely. We're on the Jade Road. Well, shorter episode this time around, but yeah, it was like the entirety of Not Menarth. What's it called again? Nelva. So thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.